What's up, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. As I promised, today we're doing Marvel Snap. Let's go ahead. I'm gonna jump in and show you around real quick. You got your level and stuff up here at the top. Basically, this game is like a turn-based TCG type of game. Well, I guess it's CCG, whichever way you want to say. It's collectible, basically, because you have a collection of cards that you start off with. As you can see, there go some of the cards you can get. I'm not that far in the game because I haven't spent any money yet, and it seems like there's a good bit of need to do that in this game. We'll get to that. I'll talk about that more later. But what I want to do is I'm going to jump in the game and show you how the game is played real quick. So as you can see, the search times, match time is really, really low. I'm going against Karnak here. Okay, so in the center you have different maps. And each map has a ability to it. So this one says unreveal effects happen twice here. So if I wanted to put somebody here who had an unreveal effect, it'll happen twice. Right there, this character doesn't have anything right there. Just say we gotta save the city. That's what the effect would be. Quicksilver has an effect, it starts in your hand. So I'm just gonna play Quicksilver over here in my turn. You do have a time limit, as you can see the person has a time, is on the timer right now. They didn't play anything, so they must be have a heavy deck. Now they start you off pretty slow until you finally hit like one of the ranks above. Like I think I'm in iron rank right now or something like that. When you play a card here, shuffle three rocks into your deck. So that's something that you're also gonna want to play late in the match. I'm going to take a chance to say that he's going to go here on this map. Star-Lord is only got on a real. Ooh, he went into the rock section. I was not expecting that because rocks are really, from experience, rocks are really, it stops you from getting so many cards. It turns into a new location in 4 turns. Okay, that location could be good or bad. Okay, Hawkeye right here has an unreveal, which means they played face down, and when they turn over, they're revealed. But it all happens in one turn. It's not like a Yu-Gi-Oh! Type of game where you gotta play it and then they'd be attacked or flipped or something like that on your own accord. No, it's just played and flipped at the same turn, as you already see. This one says if you play a card next turn here, you get more power. So right now, I think I'm just gonna play over here. Get some power over here and see what he gonna do. I could have threw Hawkeye out too because I had enough energy, which is this orb right here in the center. And the blue orb stands for energy. The orange side is how much power you have in the area. Now, the objective of the game is to win 2 areas. They snapped, so they think they're going off right now. Snapping means I'm gonna lose double of those type of power cubes. Oh my gosh, I mean they might be right on this because no, they ain't right. What we're gonna do is I'm gonna go here. No, not yet, because they're gonna make me have to play here next turn. We're gonna play right here. He snapped. He's trying to put pressure on me to quit the game. But I'm not going to quit. Play those rocks. Okay, we have rocks in our deck now. Rocks have 0 power, but they cost 1 energy. And I have a guy right here that says your 1 cost cards gets +1 power. So what we're going to do is we're going to drop him right here into our own reveal effect, because his effect is, I don't know, it's ongoing. Never mind, I thought I was gonna get a double thing right there. Well, let's just drop him. I'm gonna drop him here so we can at least fight this area. I really don't like the rocks right now. He is winning 2 sides right now, so he might have been right to snap. Give 3 power to friendly power. So he gave all his people power. See, he got Ironheart. He's either been playing the game a while and he got that card. This is going to be the last turn. I'm going to play this here. I might still win. Let's just throw this rock here just to see if we can help the power count there. I should have already threw it there. So when I put Kazar out, he would have gave them power. But, oh well. He's probably going to play something heavy on his right side and try to take the match. Never mind. He played it on the left side. I think I won there, guys. So I won because I have 2 locations with the most power there. Even though it's not as low power. I mean, this side only had 1. He only played 1 thing there, and that was a rock. And I had 13 there in the center, which is high power there. So that's how the game is played, pretty much. So I won 4 cubes off of that, which is go towards me leveling up. Now, far as leveling up your cards, I don't know if they get other abilities, but I'm going to show you right now. Punisher has never been leveled up. It's a common card right now. We're going to level it up right here. It's going to become uncommon. Bam. Frame break. Cool animation here. Basically, frame break is self-explanatory, but his animation is now popped out of outside of the frame. Now, if I go and show you a different person, we did just unlock Odin because each time you upgrade a character, you get something on this tree right here. So you do get the center for upgrading your cards, even your low level cards. But as you can see, I haven't upgraded that much yet, but we just got the Odin. So Odin has an own reveal effect. Activate only own reveal effects again. Oh, that's pretty good. He's gonna have to go on my deck. But let's go ahead and show you. I do have a couple that are upgraded to rare. I think Quicksilver is already up there to rare. So he's rare. So as you can see, he has a 3D effect to his card now. And I'm not sure how far the rarity goes up, but we'll know as we keep playing this game. But that's pretty much it for the game. Let's look at the cash op shop real quick. I'll show you that off. So they gave us a bundle, Captain America. I've seen somebody use that card, so that's probably why they had him. You get daily offers. So gold, I haven't found any kind of way to earn gold yet in this game. So it's probably a way to do it the higher level you get in rank. But as of right now, there is no way. Right here, you can fast upgrade your people. It usually has a card that's common or uncommon in here. And you can pay this amount to upgrade them. So I might do it for these characters on the outside. That's a quick plus to my level right there for that. Then you got credits down here, which I have not spent. You start off with 150 gold. And I haven't spent any money on it, so I don't plan on doing it yet. Not until I actually feel like that is worth it. But right now, as you can see, this is the gold thing. I might drop 20 on it, but I haven't decided yet. The game is really fun to play. The games are short as long as you go ahead and take your turn and don't just sit there waiting on your timer to go out. But like I said, it's a lot. It's a lot the process, not a lot the same the process. I'm going to go ahead and show you the upgrade process. This is going to upgrade Jessica Jones to uncommon, giving her the frame break. As you can see, her little thing pops out of the frame now, as well as the head comes out the top. And I don't really use her. If I upgrade 2 more times, I can get... No, 1 more time, I can get these 25 credits. So, technically, I wouldn't have to use as much. And we're going to do Wolfbane here, too. Wolfsbane. Okay. That's going to give me the 25 credits. Thank you. Meaning, I didn't spend that much. I spent 75 instead of... the 100 that I just spent, in a sense. Not really a discount, but he would be rare. I kind of like this card. All right. Let's play. Oh, you got a season pass here, right? You got a season pass here, so you're going to earn stuff as you go. As you can see, I have some stuff right now that I can hit. Avatar. 20 thing boosters. We got a card back. Oh, that's why they had Iron Heart. Okay. Iron Heart was a reward. And that'll be the next one I get. And you got Gamora and Blue Marvel was going to be the top one for this season of it. And this is recruit season because it's the beginning of the game. Oh, we got claim 3-day lunch stuff here. Let's go ahead and claim our stuff for today. The third day. Technically, it's not the third day, but I guess I did upload. Download the game when it first came out. And somebody could be upgraded here. Thing. Let's upgrade the thing. It's clobbering time, baby. Let's go. Or is... No, it's him. He upgraded again. I'll go ahead and get that. Yeah, it's 3D. 3D. Like I said, the more you upgrade your cars here, the better it is for you. We get a mystery car here. Deathlock. Destroy other cars at this location. Alright, we completed missions, so you do have a mission tab right here. And you have, I think these are the dailies up here in blue. Then you have recruit season chapter 1, and then you have chapter 2. So I'm on chapter 2 right now, and I have to do these new stuff right here. So some of these are easy. I'm just gonna go ahead and do another game right here, guys. And I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you're playing the snap. If you've played it and you like it, if you're gonna whale out on this game, let me know if it's worth it or not, guys. Cards here have 5 power. That's pretty good. I should have went there first. Okay, well, even though we didn't, we'll go here with her because she gets more power in the middle. I have not seen that card before. I might have to retreat on this one, guys. This guy kind of strong if he got cards I ain't seen before. Hulk made me discard a card. I mean, Scovia made me discard a card. Who's winning here? Get 3 powers. Bishop. I have not seen Bishop either. They tell you at the top that you haven't seen a card. I decided to play this one out too, guys. Y'all can see how I play this game a little bit. Now, see, putting Punisher here in the middle is going to be good for us. But we're not going to do it just yet. What we're going to do is... No, don't play him there. Play him there. That's going to power up this one and this one. But Namor right there, bro. Namor. I'm surprised he hadn't snapped yet because he might win this. He has a good chance of winning this. I'll play that there. Play him there. And the next turn will be the last turn. I figured he would actually do that. Play something over there. Now, if I can win this one on the outside, because it looks like I'm close to winning this one over here. Oh, actually, we're winning this one now. Did he snap? No, he didn't snap. If you play it, I can't play him there. So what we're going to do here is I'm gonna play her there. I think we have to play him here and hope that we win here. He's probably gonna play something heavy on one side or the other. Let's see what he does. Oh, I knew it. I knew it. I knew it. I knew he was gonna play something heavy somewhere. Oh, I won. We tied over here on the left side. So that's the thing. If you tie in an area, you do both get the points. So I don't know if we both got the spears, but no, we both didn't get the spears because he only was winning in one spot. That's right. So we both got tied on the right. They gave me two. All right, let's upgrade Iron Man. It's this 3D upgrade here. Hope you guys are enjoying the video. If you did, please like and subscribe. It helps me a lot on the channel. And guys, I'll see you next time.